When people go on the Physicians Committee website, believe it or not, the number one thing that they click on is gut bacteria. Can you believe it? The idea is they're affecting your physical health, they affect how you think, they affect how you sleep. Well, is this just a fad or is this real? Karen, let me start with you.
It is no fad, Neil.
This is real.
This is real. The trillions of bacteria we have in our guts really impact everything from our mood to our immune system to our metabolism. And healthy foods, high fiber foods like fruits, vegetables, whole grains, and legumes keep these bacteria healthy, whereas unhealthy foods like meat and cheese do the opposite. And this can happen really quickly.
And in fact, there was a recent study where they took 20 men from rural South Africa and 20 men from Pittsburgh, and they switched their diets. So they gave the men in Pittsburgh a traditional diet that's consumed in rural South Africa, things like legumes and peas and okra and tomatoes. And they gave the South Africans the kind of food they eat in Pittsburgh. So hot dogs and hamburgers and french fries and ice cream. And in two short weeks after switching diets, they switched their bacteria. So that the men in Pittsburgh now had the same characteristic healthy bacteria that the men in South Africa had started with. And the men in South Africa had the same unhealthy bacteria that the men in Pittsburgh started with.
So you're saying 2 weeks on a healthy diet improves your gut bacteria, 2 weeks on a bad diet makes your bacteria the disease-causing bacteria.
Exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
That's exactly right. A low-fat, plant-based diet can really improve our gut bacteria. And one of our diabetes researchers here recently wrote a paper that suggests people consume a minimum of 50 to 55 grams of fiber every day. And you can only find fiber in plants. So fruits, vegetables, whole grains, and legumes.
Okay, that number was?
50 to 55.
Where are we now? 12?
Under 20.
12, 15?
Yeah.
Okay, well, wait a minute. You're saying for healthy gut bacteria, you should be eating a plant-based diet. But most people are gonna say, for healthy gut bacteria, I go to the store and I buy a pill.
Well,
probiotics.
Well, the problem with that, high fiber foods that Karen was talking about are really serve as prebiotics. So they serve as fuel for food for those healthy bacteria to thrive. And when we take probiotics, which are meant to kind of replace or promote a healthy gut flora, trying to do that with pills when you're talking about trillions of bacteria is like trying to fill up a swimming pool with an eyedropper.
So you do it with food?
With food.
You do it with food. You can eat your prebiotics and your probiotics without taking any supplements.
Augustina, what's your take?
Yeah, you should stop the use of unnecessary antibiotics because some of you might have heard that they promote antibiotic-resistant bacteria, but the side effect not only stop there because they also kill healthy bacteria. And the use of antibiotics, believe it or not, 70% goes to animal agriculture. Wow. So if we stop eating hot dogs, hamburger, chicken, or turkey, we'll avoid those unnecessary side effects of antibiotics.
All right, a person takes an antibiotic though. They had a pneumonia, urinary tract infection, they take antibiotics. Is that the time that you should be taking a probiotic?
Well, that's never been clinically shown to be beneficial. And in fact, I think that knowing exactly what kinds of bacteria are optimal is still, we're still learning about that.
Jim, you're killing a whole industry. Yeah. As we speak, there are people, you know, they go to the store and it's like $60 for this little bottle.
Right.
You're saying, it may help, it may not help?
So what appears to be is the ratio of certain types of bacteria in a healthy gut versus an unhealthy gut. And trying to replace that very specifically, I just don't think we know enough.
Okay, you're saying healthy food.
Healthy food. Fermented foods in particular, I mean, fermented foods which are grown in the presence of bacteria seem to have the kinds of healthy bacteria that our gut need to sustain itself.
Well, I was hoping you would tell me it was a fad to tell you the truth, because it's kind of a creepy idea to think that what's going on in determining your health is nothing about your body. It's all these trillions of bacteria that live in your digestive tract. Stay tuned. I think we need a lot more research on this, but we'll see where we're going with it. Thanks for joining us.